Hi gamers, I'm Cyber Settler, and today we're playing Frontier Pilot Simulator. So I decided to make another look at this game. I've been playing it for some time now, and so now I have improved my pilot skills. And in fact, I bought this ship, like, it's the biggest one of the game. And the ride is pretty smooth. But unfortunately, I made some errors. I crashed it. And now I'm broke. Like, economically speaking, I'm broke. So I have a debt of 585 credits. I don't have power in my ship, and I cannot refuel it. I have cargo in the ship, so what my plan is to switch back again to the ship I had before and receive some credits, and with that make some money to try and buy again this ship. So let's open the hull, because we have some cargo. We need to unload it because we cannot we will be changing the ship, and so we cannot have it in the ship. Well, I don't know what would happen if I would have it in the ship and I sell the ship. So let's switch the ship. I will then load the ship again with the cargo. We're going to deliver that and see how much money do we need to buy this ship again. It's a pity that I have to sell it. But what happened the last time is that I had a really low sky level, and there I was flying through the mountains, and I crossed the ship. Let's see if here I can recharge. Oh, never mind. Well, I will get more. What it's called? My debt will increase, but we can get back that money. Okay, in fact, yeah, my debt is going up. Ah, so never mind. We will fly with this ship. Okay, and another thing that happened is that I have this cargo of this algae stuff, and there's I can sell them in the spaceport, but the spaceport is really high in the sky. It's like a floating platform, and it's above 2,000 meters. And the sky level at the time that I wanted to dock in the spaceport was 2,000 or something like that. So I couldn't get my ship to go as high as to be able to dock with the space port. Okay, but never mind. Let's load my cargo again. And let's head to the sky level currently is 39. It's above 3,900 meters. So there are some lenses here. Okay. Should we load that as well? I don't know what those lenses are doing here. Ah. No, I have those lenses. Okay. Okay, so let's go for the seaweed. So here I will select the nearest, and you see it's in that cargo spaceport. Okay, that's it. So let's go there. So for those of you who don't know the game, Frontier Pilot Simulator is, again, making reference, as I usually do, comparing games one with the other. It's like Elite Dangerous, but it takes place on a planet. You don't have a spaceship, you have these VTOL ships. And it's similar to Elite Dangerous in the sense that not only it's like this open world, right? It's an open world game where you you can sell stuff, like you can accomplish, there's different type of missions like exploring or trading, like hauling stuff, but also you have like this this world that is changing all the time. They are discovering this is an alien world, and they're all the time changing the world. Like they are discovering new species, and it seems that the world could have like some impact from the player. I'm not sure about this though. Like the players can change the world. You don't find other players in the game, or at least I haven't done that. But it seems that it's a persistent world. Also, I think there are no combat missions. Until now, I have performed like this passenger transport, exploring, hauling, things like that. And there is this very useful, well, this ship, if you saw my last video, this ship is more smooth, the ride is smoother than the Ox. This is the Balena, or in Spanish we'll say ballena. But yeah, this is a bigger ship, and it's more stable, it's faster as well. So let's switch to the other, and this is the spaceport, and I hope I'm not going too high. Okay, that's the place where I have to land, in this green area you see there. And this one is a really good, a pretty nice station. The spaceport is a flying station, or a floating station. Wow, what was that? It looks like some sort of plane. Let's see what happened to our depth with this mission here. Wow, that was a good landing there. Okay. So let's see, the seaweed we can sell. Ah, that's great. Yeah, so we are in the positive again. We can sell this house as well, but I think it's not convenient to sell it here. Here. In the hard mine. Hard mine. Also, you see that there's some ore around the hard mine. So this is also a way to make money, right? To collect ore or to collect samples around the planet and to sell them. Okay. So in hard mine we can... Yeah, I'm going to buy this Lynx drones and we are going to go to Harmony. I don't know what was that about. Let's load this. We're going to Harmony now. What is the weather condition? This is an issue here because this station is so high in the sky and you have these sky level events where the some part of the atmosphere at certain level gets radiation and it messes up your ship. So no, not yet. I need to load. I think they change. Did they change this interface? Like you were able to load the energy to recharge your batteries in this landing site. But now it seems that we have to go into the hangar for that. I'm not sure if this is correct. But it's very good. One thing that is very good is that I didn't have to sell the ship. So I get to like show you guys the ship. It has a greater tonnage, it's faster, and it's more stable. All very good things. Okay, so let's recharge the batteries. And you can see the sun in the background is rising. Nice view. Sometimes the sun, if it's in front of you, it blocks your sight. So I want to get... Ah, it's a sunset. It's not like the sun is rising. It's a sunset. Okay, but I want to go... There's a cargo box here. I'm not sure what is it. About. Sometimes I find these cargo boxes in like random cargo boxes lying around. I'm not sure what is that about. Okay, we're good to switch. Let's decrease the speed. Why are we going down so fast though? The lenses are very fragile, as you can see. It has like this red bar, and to the right, and these dots to the left. So you can see that there's like a gauge there, and if you go into the red area, you will damage the cargo. That's what it means. And we're going into like this mountain region, and you have this other view. And in this view, it's good to fly if the visibility is poor, right? If you have poor visibility, but also it gives you information about the surroundings, like these arrows. This means that we have all that. We have like a wind speed there. So I will switch to okay, we are good. So we have like this block. We can block like the vertical thrust, and it's easier to control the ship vertical speed while you block the throttle, because otherwise you have to be very precise. I'm playing with a gamepad. I think it's the best way to play the game. If you have a joystick or a HOTAS, I can imagine that it's a better experience still. There we go. Wow, the lenses are already damaged. They are at 67%. I didn't see that. So at some point they were damaged. That's bad. It says 67%. Okay, and here there's a passenger. There. Okay, let's sell this. And I will sell the lenses as well. Ah, they don't buy it. Ah, yes. They buy it, but not at full price. Okay, but I am in a better shape than I was before. Now we have 19,000 credits. So what I was going to do, let's see. There's some ore and cargo lying around. Okay. Let's see, we're going to go to that cargo. Maybe that's something I had when I crash or something. Let's go to that cargo. First I will recharge. Also we can pick up some ore to see how it goes. So that's it. So that cargo is to somewhere in this direction. 200 meters. Okay, there's some more down there. Let's go and pick it up. I'm going too fast. I think this one is in a better place. There. There we are. So the ore is back here. So this is not exactly mining. I wouldn't call this mining though. But if you find this ore lying around, you can just open your cargo hold and you can pick them up. So you see there is this raw tritium. No, terbium, sorry. Terbium. I don't know what kind of mineral is that. And I can see where can I sell it? Select the nearest destination. Okay. That's the nearest. Not sure what is that. And select the most profitable. I think it's the same. Okay, so that's it. There is another one. I think we could also get it. 900 meters. Well, probably it's better. We could go rolling or we could go flying. But what? Which are those coordinates? This is strange. It says 3 kilometers away. Sky level will be reduced soon. 1.5 kilometer. This is the dangerous sky level, because all this region we are in right now is this really rough terrain. A lot of mountains and volcanoes and stuff. But I think I cannot carry more, right? Current capacity 7,000. Yeah, probably I cannot take any more. So yeah, let's go to that place instead. With this other view, you can also see with this like infrared thing, you can also see the sky level, you see? Like the this grid at the top is like a ceiling. This is the sky level. So it's also helpful to keep away from the sky level. This other view. And I don't know what's that marking. When I selected to plot the nearest and the most profitable place to sell this ore, it marked these blue coordinates right there. This is the hard mine. But strange, why it marked it like this blue thing? That's weird. I'm already low on power. Very strange. It marked those coordinates. It seems that it's the like the mines, right? Oh, that would make sense. They would buy the ore in the mine. So they will, I don't know, maybe there's a refinery here. Ah, there's a cargo there. Okay. Let's see what's that. It seems that it's showing that place. Oh, that's strange. Okay, I cannot sell it here. Why was it? No, I assume that it's an error of the. It's some, I don't know, some bug. I will sell the ore here in the mine. But in the meanwhile, I will see what happens if I again some lenses. What happens if I load it? I think I cannot load it. Okay. Loaded limit exceeded, okay. Okay, let's sell this. Yeah, so there we go. I can sell the terbium ore for 4,662 credits. So it's like a short trip. You don't invest money buying the ore, but of course it will deplete your energy. So that's part of the cost. Let's see, where is this guy going? Let's take him. Let's open the cargo hold. There we go. Let's set the destination. Oh, it's really far away, huh? And he wants to get there in 8 minutes. Yeah, sure. But it's really far away. And what's the sky level? Well, this is a risky mission right here. Bori. He's going to Bori. Oh, it's getting... We cannot go over 1500, so... There we go. We're good. Well, that transition was nice. So you see the sky level, right? It's not... The sky level is very close. We cannot go over 1500. And you see the volcano, hot air going up. Okay, that's 77 kilometers now. I'm not sure if I have that kind of fuel. But let's try it. How can we... Maybe we can spare some fuel going slower? I don't know. Going faster will burn more fuel, I think. Faster, I mean. more fuel faster. And this guy wants to be there in 8 minutes. This is the thing with the passengers. They have like this limited time. And if you go past that time, then they pay less proportionally of what they offer you initially. Okay, so these VTOLs, they have these two flying modes, alright? Like the VTOL mode and the plane mode. Or horizontal mode. And of course, the if you fly like a plane, you are more efficient with the fuel consumption. You don't consume fuel as fast, and then you can go farther away. Also, it's faster than the VTOL mode, but not the ship you begin the game with. It's a small ship. It doesn't have the plane mode. Oh, we are very high now. We should get lower us up because the sky level, we're very close to the sky level. It's at 2000, and funny things start happening when you approach the sky level. Really funny things. One thing is that your radar will be messed up, and sometimes if you're long enough in this radiation area, your engine will turn off. Yeah, pretty bad stuff. Also, I think you can get some damage in your equipment. I think I've never been... I never... travel so far, I think, with this plane. Over 80 kilometers it was, right? But I think we will make it. I think. Oh, again, he's so... It went past the sky level. Bori. Okay, we are already 5 minutes. He wants to be there in 8 minutes. I don't know if this is possible. I think these missions are too tight, too time tight. I think they should give you more time to transport the passengers. So this Bori is in the middle of the sea, right? I think. Okay, we need to reduce the or altitude because we will be tight on the fuel. We will be tight on the fuel here. Let's see. We're almost there. Almost there. So we have to get... Wow, okay. Low fuel. We need to go faster. Well, the 8 minutes are up, you see? This is what I hate about these missions. We're always late. Yeah, get up from his ship. Now he will pay what he wants. Oh, that's not bad. 40,000. It's not that bad. Okay, so let's let's end it here, guys. So this is another episode of Frontier Pilot Simulator. Well, we got a good view for the episode ending. You can see that there's a planet with rings in the background. I've never seen that planet. It's a beautiful landscape here, and as I said before, this is a game to relax. I said chilling game, but chilling could be interpreted as a terrifying game. Okay, but it's chilling in the sense that you chill out, you know what I mean. So I hope you like the video and hope to see you in the next one. This is Cyber Settler signing off.